ना करे कॉफी आला कर पे सर तो 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 2 मिनट आ गेम रे आ लाइव रे रे गेम रे अबे रिक्वेस्ट रिक्वेस्ट
प्लीज सर
Not the human startup. See, I'm first of all to my right is Advocate Shankar Phatte, Block President of Porvori, and my colleague. Now, I would like to place before you all be first is that on 14th May 2020, I had written a letter to the Revenue Minister detailing discrepancies and well-founded allegations of fake certificates. At that point, it was only fake certificate. Okay, now everybody knows it is no more a private affair. The post of Awal Karkun has come under tremendous criticism of the general public, of activists, of politicians. Moreover, the worst affected are the candidates who appear for the test. They are young, budding youth of our state, which we say is the pillar and the future resources. Our government seems to be busy, or many seem to be busy, many politicians, as far as resources are concerned, they believe it is only as far as money is concerned. There is no resource that can replace the youth of the state. They are the resources. They will build up this economy that has been collapsed. But we cannot allow them to be collapsed. This post of Awal Karkun, to give you a short history, has not been advertised for the first time. This was advertised during the tenure of Parsekar. It was advertised again during the tenure of Manohar Parrikar. And now once again in January 2016, on 25th August, this was held, what do you call that? 24th January 2019, this post was advertised. 24th January 2019, remember this. The whole of January has gone and half of 20 is gone. And how in the last 1 month, the hurry in getting this post appointed with issuing appointment letters at various positions. Now, for this post, when they were advertised, 5,600 candidates were called for the preliminary exams, which was held around 25th August 2019. Now, from January to 2019, exams are held after over 5, 6, 7 months. Okay? Out of the preliminary exam, 173 candidates were shortlisted. The 173 candidates' final exams were held around 18th January. Now from 173 candidates were shortlisted, exams were held on 25th of August. Then you are calling these 173 candidates in 18th January. So from August to January, what was happening? what sort of manipulations were happening to finalize those 173 candidates. The government has to explain this. Forget the politicians. Forget the people. It is the candidate, 4,000, almost 4,000 candidates who appeared for the exams have been felt let down and totally dejected that after doing the best, they were sidelined. Therefore, the explanation is to come to these almost 4,000 to 5,000 candidates who attended for the examination. They are totally dejected. You are frustrating them to such an extent that they are under psychological pressure. And if you try to derail them from the thought process of a bright future, we are bringing a disaster to our state and the future of our state. Now, exams were held on 18 January 2020. Final exams were held on that optical mark recognition. The delay of the results, they are totally, what do you call that, computerized. It could be made, the result could be out within 48 hours. Take a week. But the results were so long delayed that it gave scope. And genuinely, the youth who appeared were put under such a trauma, not knowing what their fate is. Till the end of April, no results were declared. 16 candidates' names were finally declared. Then came up the charge of the fake certificate scam. Now when there was a fake certificate scam and later on a bribery charge, and to add fuel to the fire, a BJP prominent leader, an ex-MLA of the Panaji constituency, who is supposed to be of the inner core of the Bharatiya Janata Party, made a demand that this should be scrapped, all these posts, so that a fair and proper selection be done and pass a message to all the aspiring candidates that no hera-phiri will be tolerated and will give no scope for any suspicion. Here this is not to be suspicion, matters are proved. Where they had to finally drop the student, one of them. Then you bring an additional list person there. Okay. Now when all this is going on, I'll refresh your memory by saying that in the English paper, question paper, there was a question that raised that showing that people, that youth are aspiring, have got no faith in the system, and aspiring to go abroad because the job prospects and their prospects seem to be very, very bleak. But on the contrary, the audacity of the Bharatiya Janata Party, office bearers who have no heart for the youth of our state, have a press conference and demand an inquiry against this teacher who said the paper. Now, I would like to ask the Bharatiya Janata Party office bearers who took that press conference and talking nonsense, absolutely nonsense. Apart from the parents, who else better knows the child or the student? It is the teacher. And with all this happening, it has only proved that what was questioned was because she knew what was troubling the minds of those innocent children. And therefore that question was put. It's something out of the blues, that everything is transparent, everything is perfect, and suddenly something has come in the picture. This is going on for donkey's years. That people have to bribe, people have to have a godfather. No merits work here. So, the BJP has shown that it has got a ruthless heart towards this youth. Now, on 10th June, the governor wrote a letter asking for austerity measures. The 10th June announcements are made in the papers that austerity measures, first measure would be freezing appointments. All recruitments to be frozen. It is a total sore pierce to the heart of the youth of this state. When you are telling them, we don't care for you, no jobs will be given to you, there are so many things. Cut down the cabinet, there are so many austerity measures. But for your austerity measures means only money. I'll come to that after. After having made that announcement, the appointment of Awal Karkun made by an order dated 25-6-2020. On 10th you say that it is frozen. On 25th you issue the appointment orders. Now what is this hurry for? When there is a UN cry about the authenticity of this whole results, of this whole examination that has been held by. Students are in, the aspirants are in turmoil. Everybody is in turmoil. Now, it is a known fact that the scope of employment in this pandemic has come to its lowest. And therefore, the youth, the educated youth, the semi-educated youth have known that prospects of a good, bright future to even survive seems to be out of their reach. And therefore, we must understand that this tender minds and hearts are under tremendous pressure, and by doing so, by just ignoring them, nobody seems to be talking about them. We are forcing them to take wrong paths in their life. And circumstances will force them. Standard of living has reached so high. They were used to live so high on their parents' cost, on whatever it was. There were a lot of side businesses could be done. Economy was there blooming. But when everything collapses, how do they survive? Now, there was a vision document of the Bharatiya Janata Party, which was drawn for the 2012 elections. And in the employment, they had stated that allowances would be given. Unemployment, employment guarantee scheme. 1 minute. Yeah. This is not my document. This is the document of the BJP. 2012-2017 Goa Vision Document Election Manifesto. Where the very first point in the employment, an allowance of ₹3,000 to ₹4,000 per month will be paid under the minimum employment assurance scheme. Where is the scheme? Where is the scheme? Let's forget it. Can there be any opportune time to give a psychological boost to this youth by now implementing the scheme? What was promised by you? Again, jumlas. Maine wo jumla kiya tha 15 lakh ka, ye bhi jumla. Even if it was jumla and people, the youth have kept quiet, and many of the youth again voted you all to power. And during the Lok Sabha, not for the assembly. Assembly they were routed. Because one of these factors. Now, implement that scheme in this pandemic so that psychology, you will give them a boost that the government and the people of Goa are concerned about the youth, and we cannot afford, because if there is any resource that has to be preserved, it is the youth of this state. They will bring up this economy that has collapsed. But if you allow them to collapse and get derailed, you are ruining Goa forever. Therefore, I demand that the employment scheme guaranteed with the allowance of 3,000 to 4,500 per month, that whether today 3,000, 4,500 per month will be sufficient, not sufficient, when laborers are paid 6,000, government should announce it, but immediately this should be done. And since no provision has been made in the budget, we demand that provision be made in the budget and see that from 1st of August, that the youth of this state who are unemployed throughout Goa are given an allowance. Put the promise at least now. Don't be so hard-hearted and say issue orders, issue inquiries against teachers whose ear is close to the heart of every student and understands them. Next to the parents, anybody understands? Repeat it again, it is the teachers. And therefore that teacher should be actually felicitated for having brought this to the knowledge where even the whole government was shaken up. Are you sleeping? If somebody wakes you up, what are you trying to say? A thief has come to your house, fast asleep, fellow, not bothered, what is happening? Goa is burning here. So it is a serious demand that this be put into effect with immediate effect and save the youth of this state. Thank you.
What about the people who has lost their jobs during this
year? That automatically falls into place, no? Automatically falls into the place. I'm talking of all unemployed, but first, you stick to your promise of unemployed. When a person who has lost his job is unemployed, he falls into that net.
How do you see the future?
I shall explain to you, no? If this attitude, Kerahang attitude of the unemployed youth continues to be of the state, you are ruining the resources of our state. Sarkara resource means paise hai. Ani kaya padong na? Yam ke resource. If this collapses, you gave package to mining, what do you call it, dependence. Fair enough. Nobody is against it. But what is the need today, Mudhav? Can you allow the youth of this state to get mentally frustrated and choose paths to ruin their life totally, forever? And by doing that, ruin the state together.
As said, the labor amount is being given 6,000. What should be the youth amount according to you?
It should not be better than laborers. I am crying.
Figure out how much overall.
No, I am crying. Implement it first. Decide to implement it. Include whatever you have. So many crores or rupees are spending. Nobody will get to go business class. Why business class when stopped even going by economy class? What nonsense is that? For what are they going? Five officers, six officers? Minister, minister's family. It is there for the government to decide, no? What do you feel? But my question is, make them feel they are wanted. You have totally discarded them. Not even uttering a word about them. And when there is such a hullabaloo about this 10 post, what are the hurry to appoint them? which is going on for the last 2 years. Exams are held in January, results in August, my Anikide results, Anikide, and last of all, last when there is pressure mounting, when the Pandora's box is opening, where all stops of suspicions are given strength and it is energized by various facts or strong charges, you are in a hurry appointing this post. What is the hurry?
By producing the fake certificates, is it so easy to get a job so in Goa?
My question is, where are all the certificates have been checked of all these people? Now only one. Somebody pointed out to you one. Are there inside more? Is the question.
Is it only in this or in the other vacancies and posts, whether in the other departments also?
Government should have been strict and sent every certificate for verification in this case. In this particular case, all the certificates should have been sent for verification, which were being selected first. And as a stand back, now they are given, when the fellow who is supposed to have got a fake certificate, he is out, waiting this fellow is brought in. What is the hurry, man? Where is the hurry? When those 16 were being selected, the Haffa had already started about fake. So they have conveniently put the waiting list fellow of their choice on the first list. It's common sense, man. You don't require scientific brains for this. When the selection was going on, about the fake certificate, when the Awaz took place, knowing very well that he would be selected, knowing very well he will be rejected, you are already putting one person on first on the list. So he goes there.
Some people out there are asking and demanding for the resignation.
Of?
Resignation.
Resignation of whose? I resign. What is this resignation? I am not understanding. Problem solved. I want to save the youth, man. If tomorrow some I die, the problem is solved. What is this resignation? I am not. Who's asked for resignation? I don't know. On what resignation? On what issue?
So basically, the youth futures have been in doubt. In click,
you see that. My dear, I am not making a charge. This is a fact. Have an interview with various youth of this state and they will tell one side the minister is saying all recruitment frozen. No jobs. Industries are removing people. So where they are going to go? You want to make them gangsters? What is it?